Let's play a mathematical game I call Swine in a Line. It starts with 9 pigs and a row of 9 pig pens we want to put them into. Some of the pens contain a pig at the start of the game, other pens start out empty. Two players take turns putting pigs into pens until every last pen has exactly one pig in it, and the player who put in that last pig wins. When it's your turn to move, you can put a pig into an empty pen, or you can put a pig into a pen that already has a pig in it, and then something interesting happens. One of the pigs in the pen jumps one pen to the left, and the other jumps one pen to the right. Left, right. This doesn't count as a separate turn. It's just a consequence of the player's choice to put a pig into a pen that already had a pig in it. But I'm not done with consequences, because if the jumps cause another pen to have two pigs in it, then, you guessed it, those pigs jump. Left, right. When a pig jumps to the left from the pen on the far left, or jumps to the right from the pen on the far right, then that pig just goes back to wandering in the field. Left, right. The rule is, whenever a pen has two or more pigs in it, one pig in that pen jumps left, and another pig in that pen jumps right. Left, right. The chain reaction continues until every pen has at most one pig in it. After all the consequences of your move have played themselves out, it's time for your opponent to make a move, which, if your opponent chooses to put a pig in a pen that's already occupied, will result in another chain reaction that will eventually settle down. And then you make another move, and so on. This process goes on until someone makes a move that results in every pen containing exactly one pig, and then the player who made that move wins. Can you figure out how to win this game? For instance, if it's your turn to move, and there are pigs in pens 2, 7, and 9, what's the best move? It turns out there's only one winning move. Because this is a mathematical game, it's really more of a puzzle. It just happens to be a puzzle where the goal is to find the secret strategy for winning a game. It's fun to solve the puzzle with a friend, where you take turns making moves in the game. But you're working together to solve the puzzle, so your goal is to figure out what's really going on, not to win games. In fact, a good way to solve this puzzle is, if at some point you see a way to immediately win, don't do it. Keep playing with a non-winning move, and keep track of what happens. You and your friend may notice a pattern that unlocks the secrets of the game. I'll post another video next week that gives a hint about the winning strategy for this game. In the meantime, have fun. And if you solve this puzzle, please let me and others know what your thought process was, because how one solves a puzzle is at least as important as what the solution is. To reply, view the June 2017 entry at barefootmath.blog and go to the comments section. And remember, I don't care if you're Gauss or Euler, if your comment is a spoiler, please do label it as a spoiler. Happy puzzling!